an opening from the Bible. Matthew chapter 5, verse 9. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. As police officers, we are also peace keepers. And we are blessed because we are children of God. It is a great honor to be appointed to head such a noble institution like the police service. The role of this institution is indispensable in the maintenance of peace and order in the country. I am highly grateful and would like to seize this wonderful occasion to thank His Excellency Nana Addo Dankwa Addo for entrusting me with the responsibility to lead the men and women of this wonderful organization that I have served for the past 29 years. I also wish to express my gratitude to the people of Ghana for their expression of support and their praise. I am inspired and also humbled by the confidence that you have placed in me and accept the outpouring of support as an indication of the national commitment from the people of Ghana to work hand in hand with the Ghana Police Service in ensuring the safety of all Ghanaians. I am relying on the grace of God to offer an excellent service to the police service in particular and to the nation as a whole. My faith is strong and I firmly believe I will succeed with God's blessings. The responsibility of leadership of the Ghana Police Service is not a job for the faint-hearted. And I ask you to pause for a moment to acknowledge the contributions of my predecessors towards the attainment of the current respectable and dignified position of the Ghana Police Service locally and on international platforms, especially in matters of peacekeeping mission duties outside Ghana. I have learned a lot from these retired and deceased Inspectors General of Police. As previous Inspectors General of Police, you know only too well the successes and the failures, the victories and the defeats, and the awesome responsibility that has rested on your shoulders. Even as you have led the men and women of this organization, you have also mourned with the grieving mothers and fathers who have lost their sons and daughters to violence, and with the bereaved families of the members who have given their lives in service to this country. On behalf of all the men and women of the Ghana Police Service, I thank you for your service. I want to assure the people of Ghana that, under my leadership, the Ghana Police Service will do everything within its power to respond to your concerns about the conduct of the police. We will ensure that there is accountability at all levels in the Ghana Police Service, and our police officers will be held to the highest standards of integrity. The communities that we serve has come to rely on the police as protectors of their rights. This is the only basis upon which we can build respect and mutual trust between the people of Ghana and the police who serve them. As we pursue our goal to make Ghana a safer society, we will discharge our duties with absolute impartiality and with a firm commitment to the rule of law. This will assure every Ghanaian of their right to equal treatment under the law and ensure that no citizen is seen above the law. The Ghana Police Service that we know today has come a long way since its creation. We've seen the move towards the creation of a more professional service, and today our members are better trained and equipped to deal with the challenges that we face. But there is more. Much more to be done. As our environment changes, technological advancements require that we develop operational strategies that will allow us to respond to new challenges. It requires us to be agile and rapidly respond to any issue that may arise that will require require our attention. I have decided not to take a piecemeal or ad hoc approach to improving or modernizing the police. I have embarked on a structured and strategic transformational agenda to ensure that the whole organization changes for good, improving both operations and the welfare of the officers and their families. We must continue to use the force multipliers of technology and intelligence-led and community policing to make us more efficient and effective. But we must also be prepared to make changes in our way of thinking and our modus operandi that will result in the transformation of our organizational culture to achieve our vision to become a world-class police organization capable of delivering planned, democratic, protective, and peaceful service up to the standards of international best practices. The Ghana Police Service maintains primary responsibility for the fight against crime. But we understand the critical contribution of our many partners. We will therefore continue to work hand in hand with the private sector, community leaders, other law enforcement agencies, human rights advocates, civil society groups, and our international partners to achieve our vision of becoming a world-class police.